in his heart. Did he say that? Your God, did he say that? Then how could you have long leg contest and beauty contest and beach bum contest? No, you tell me. No, this is what Jesus, this is your Lord says, your God says. And this eye of yours is causing you to do this, it will take you to hell. Rather than that happen, take it out. Take it out and throw it away. This hand is going to fondle other people's wives and daughters. It will lead you to hell. Cut it off, man. Cut it off. This is what the teachings are there, but you don't want to follow any one of them. They call the Muslims barbarians. For certain crimes, it's the chop of the guy's hands. For certain other crimes, a chop of his head, man. No. This guy here, a rapist, the guy who killed six children. He's got 6 life-year sentences, six, from the age of 2 to 12. 6 girls, I think, he killed. And he's enjoying now what is called a 6 life sentences. You know what it means? That if the guy dies and comes back, put him in life sentence. And he put him back and he dies and he's born again, put him again. What the hell are you talking about? That guy will be out in 20 years' time for good behavior and write his memoirs and make a million out of that. This is your culture. You are inviting all this. Go to the Bible. Go to your Bible, man. You don't want to touch the Quran? Don't touch the Quran. Come. I'll show you your Bible, what your Bible says. But no, you don't want to know your Bible. Because your Bible will bring you to the Quran. Yes, my sisters, your daughters. That 100 rands. 100 rands. Two reasons why a Muslim is not likely to have this book.
Because the Quran and the Hadith, we don't need this book.
Anybody else?
Sorry.
Two reasons.
Because we haven't been educated to learn more about other religions, so when we talk to people from other faiths, to be able to converse with them and perhaps bring them around to Islam, because of the ignorance that we are in, we don't want to know anything else about any other religion. That's one reason. And the second reason also could be that because we have found actually what we have, that there's no need to search for something else.
Next one. Anybody else, please? I don't want to take this 100 rand back. I want to leave it to my daughters. I want to give it to one of my child here. Come. Please, try. Very easy. Wallah, it's very easy. As a matter of fact, I told you already. Come. Huh?
It's too expensive.
Come. Two reasons. All right, I won't keep you. One last try, please. Take it, I want to give this money. All right, you, my brothers, come on. For you as well. Two reasons why a Muslim is not likely to have this book. Two reasons.
Let me try.
Yes.
One is written by a Christian, two is too expensive.
Next one.
Mixed marriage.
Now I give you, now I take you out of your suspense and put my money back in my pocket. You see, we Muslims are a La Ikra community. Means we are a people who don't read. We are not a reading people, number one. We don't even read newspapers. Do you know that? That's one reason. We are not a reading people. No Muslim magazine can survive in South Africa without charity. Do you know that? The Al Kalam, charity. Anything else, charity. You don't subscribe for any newspapers. You go and ask my friend, Mr. Muhammad Makki, the Muslim Digest, how he struggles to keep it alive. Not because you don't subscribe for things. You expect the guy to come along and persuade you to get the money out of you. You are not a reading people. We are not a reading people. We are a La Ikra community. The first word of Wahi, Allah gives our Nabi and through him to us, is Ikra, read. And we would say La Ikra, don't read. No, that's kufr, but we don't say that. But in our life, we are not a reading people. Number one reason, we are not a reading people. Number two, $59.99. Two reasons. This is the answer I wanted from you. Number one, we are not a reading people. And number two, $59.99. too expensive. Some of them said, you said that, but I wanted this too. We are not a reading people, and we are, this $59.99 is a rip-off. It's a rip-off. And we don't want to be ripped off. وآخر الدعوان علينا الحمد لله رب. We'll end with a dua. We'll end with a dua.
نبي وأهل بيتي الكرام الفاتحة. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم ربنا تقبل منا فإنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا ذلك الفضل من الله وكفى بالله عليما ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد اللهم اجعل هذا جمعنا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما اللهم اشرح صدورنا بالإسلام اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان اللهم حبب إلينا الإسلام اللهم حبب إلينا القرآن وزينهم في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والظلم والعصيان واجعلنا يا الله من الراشدين واجعلنا يا الله من المؤمنين واجعلنا يا الله من المتقين واجعلنا يا الله من الصابرين واجعلنا يا الله من الموحدين واجعلنا يا الله من الموحدين واجعلنا يا الله من الموحدين واجعلنا يا الله من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب واجعلنا يا الله من الهادين مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم اللهم افتح لنا بالخير واختم لنا بالخير واجعل عواقب أمورنا بالخير بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين